What are you doing up here? I thought you were downstairs boxing chocolates.
Oh, they kicked me out of there fast.
Why?
I kept pinching them to see what kind they were. This is the fourth department I've been in.
Oh, I didn't do so well either.
No. All right, girls. Now, this is your last chance. If one piece of candy gets past you and into the packing room unwrapped, you're fired.
Yes, ma'am.
Let her roll!
Oh, this is easier.
Yeah, we can handle this, okay?
And I wanted to share with everybody, and sometimes I sit here on an individual basis, you guys, as patients coming in, I don't get a chance to tell you everything that I want to tell you. Oh my God, you know what else you can do? You can do this and this and this. So I like doing this. This is a talk, this is kind of the abridged version of the talk that I've done in Lake Tahoe, we've done in Vegas. I do extra talks in Vegas.
You can do this here, huh?
Well, you know, we'll see how this today plays out. But today, we've got 45 minutes. I'm going to try to get you out of here in 45 minutes. So there's going to be a lot of information coming in here. And what I want you guys to do is walk away with a little something. But today, basically, we're going to talk about what is stress. And there's a big misconception about what it is and what we want to call it. The next thing is, I want you to know that the body is smart. And this is going to be a premise that you're going to need to know on that, because that's going to break down if you know that. Homeostasis. I didn't mean for there to be big words and stuff like that, but it's something that if you understand homeostasis and how the body works, you can make better healthcare decisions about everything. You're not going to get all caught up in, you know, what Dr. Oz says this week, what Oprah said that last week. You'll be able to make your own decision. That's going to be the important thing. What we're going to talk about is pathology or disease and some stuff like that. And many people are going, oh no, my eyes are already glazing over. Pathology, just about what goes wrong in your body. And this is the most important thing. I want you guys to understand what happens to your body during stress. And it's a lot more than you think. And ultimately, I want you to tell you this class is not about stress at all. This is about you and how you function in your environment, and how you're going to feel today, as opposed to how you're going to feel by the time this is over. So, this is the good one. This is interactive mode. Hold this. Write down whatever you hear. What causes stress?
People.
Money.
Money.
I want to see how fast you can.
Work.
Work.
Health.
Health causes stress.
Physical activity.
Physical activity?
She's out.
Cheater, cheater, pumpkin eater. What else do we got?
Overload.
Kids.
Chiropractor appointment.
Spouses.
Anxiety.
Smart-ass patients. What else we got?
Anxiety.
Traffic.
Public speaking.
Public speaking. You hate that. Anything else?
Flying.
Flying.
Or not flying.
Not flying.
When you're supposed to.
I'm down with you.
Family problems.
Well, you've seen doctor writing. You guys would have been here all day. Well, what the heck? Now, with that being said, what's stress cause?
Pain.
Illness.
Anxiety. Sleeplessness,
insomnia,
high
blood pressure,
hormone release.
Wow, aren't we getting physiology?
Wait, which one is it? I can't remember.
Loss of memory.
I know it's not endorphins.
Isn't it
stress?
There's no asking the teacher for
bonus.
Anything else?
Overeating.
Bad moods.
Yeah. You said that kind of grumpy.
Attitude.
Attitude.
Skin trouble. Physical ailments.
Oh, that's just bull. Physical ailments, that's everything. Can you be a little more specific?
Right.
Okay, that's good. This will help us. Boo-boos. So, that makes sense. What stress causes? What? I want you to keep those in mind for a second. I mean, we're going to talk about homeostasis. All that means is that sort of body's natural state. Does anybody not know what that means? Anybody heard that, homeostasis? All it is that if when one thing happens to the body will react and shift to kind of neutralize itself. And this happens a lot during stress. So if I turn up the heat in here, and we start going like that, and we start sweating, that's a homeostatic thing. That our body is releasing water over here to cool our bodies off. So that kind of brings us back to normal, because otherwise we would not want to boil. We have anything like that. If we get thirsty, we start getting low in water, we have dehydration or anything like that. We're going to start to get thirsty, so that our body's going to crave some water to come in. This happens every portion from the cellular level, into your tissues, to your body, into communities, that we have a homeostasis. Always will go back into balance. So with the big words and everything, all I want you to remember is that the body's smart. It knows what it's doing. It does things for a reason. Well, people will go, oh, my darn trick knee, or this, my heart palpitations, or that. There's a reason behind that. We may not know the reason right away, but we can find these out. So the first thing is, your body is smart. But what's it telling us? What's it actually trying to tell us? So if we're sweating, it's telling us, dude, we're hot. Cool us down. Get us out of this environment. Let's shift. Let's do something else. Let's get back into natural balance. If we swing one way, something's going to happen. It's going to try to shift us back. Last thing is, when we're having symptoms, when we're having problems, most of us have been trained to ask the wrong question. My back hurts. We're in a chiropractic office. My back hurts. How do I make the pain go away? Very rarely when we sit in the room over here with patients, someone would say, what's wrong with it? I mean, what caused this other than it's the first thing, it's a knee-jerk reaction. But we've been trained to do that since, let me check out, see how old everyone is. How old are you?
29.
You're old. You're not holding nothing. Marcus Welby, MD, okay? I said it, it's out there. But since we've been trained that doctor's orders and doctor said, it was like magic when you had to go to the doctor. Because remember going to the doctor back in the day, and it was an event. But if you got a doctor's order, you could do anything that you want. It's very interesting for me going through school and learning, and going, oh, doctor's order, and then learning stuff behind the curtain. Oh my God, they're not that smart. I got a lot of a school from when we could base it around something else. But we need to ask better questions. And this is where we get into the fight or flight. Everybody heard of fight or flight? It's kind of common around there. The main thing, if you look back on this, it's for survival. Not long-term survival, it's survival right now. So, if we're, why don't you guys just relax for a minute? Just kind of chill out. And I want you to pretend that we're back, we're cave people.
What?
We're
back what?
We're cave people.
Cave people.
Men and women. We're in a beautiful cave, and it's a nice fall day, and everything's sitting back over there, and everybody's, the sun's just coming up, and it has that special fall-like smell, and almost like ozone. It's kind of cool. You can smell the moisture in the air. You hear the birds outside, and the pterodactyls are falling. And you reach out, and you come out of your cave, and you get a nice big stretch. You go down, you can see the crystal clear creek over there. And there's a nice little pathway over there. There's a lot of shrubbery over there. You walk down in the sand. It's a well-beaten path. You've taken 1,000 times before. You reach down. You can see the glistening of the dew off the different leaves. And you sit over there and you can actually see things move around. You're just in nature. Beautiful moment. Then you reach down. Crystal clear water. Feel the coolness in your hands, and you know expectantly what it's going to be like, and you just kind of put it on your face and wipe the sleep off there. And you dip in,
A saber-toothed tiger comes running out of the bush, and what happens?
She gets mad at you.
But what happened, that's exactly what happened. It's a stress response that happened. So what's the first thing that happened to her right now?
She almost kicked
her. But that's not a stress response. That happens all the time.
Physical reaction.
First thing is you notice something that happens in your environment that's startling, unexpected, or unaware. So your body's not going, healthy saber-toothed tiger, friendly one. You're not going to be making these calculations. What you're doing is, well, that's something like that, we have to go like that. But what's the first thing that happens in here? If we look behind the curtain about what's going on during stress, is we're going to see that the adrenals are going to give off cortisol. I'm going to give you a lot of information. You don't have to try to memorize it, and I'm not going to try to explain every detail, but just kind of we'll go back over the premise. The cortisol. Have you guys heard of cortisol?
Mm-hmm.
That's a stress hormone that gets released from the adrenal glands when we're scared, startled. Is that the one you're talking about?
That's the one I'm talking
about. But that's the first thing that. So your body is telling you what at that time?
Something's up.
So your body is going to use everything that it can because it needs energy, right? It needs energy now. We need rocket fuel now. Saber-toothed tiger, it's Dr. Janeshak, it's one of them, but I got to get out of here. You know, so everything's going to, so your body's going to do everything. Remember, your body's smart. So it's going to go into all its closets, and it's going to figure out what you need, because it already knows. It just takes us years to figure it out. So it's going to increase our heart rate. Why is it going to increase our heart rate? More blood, faster.
More nutrients, sugar, nutrient, fabric.
Everything now. Increase the blood pressure. Why?
Because your heart rate speeds up.
Bam! So, and we have to deliver blood and nutrients and everything faster than we did before because I'm after it. Well, I'm an angel fan too, so maybe I will go after you, Michelle, if you. Increased blood glucose.
Gives you the energy you need to go.
Energy. What's the three things that your body uses for energy? glucose, proteins, and fats, right? Is that new news to anybody? Okay, yeah, so that's kind of new. So that your body's going to be looking for these. So it's going to increase triglycerides. Those are blood fats. You guys aware of what triglycerides are? So we're going to be looking in that. It's going to increase cholesterol. Okay, now here's a tricky one. Why do we need cholesterol? You guys know what cholesterol does in the body? You know cholesterol is good, right? Our body makes it, and it's good. It makes cell bodies, hormones, and it's a big portion of our brain. So when someone calls you a fathead, Carl, you're being complimentary. We have good HDL, good cholesterol, and bad cholesterol. No, we have appropriate cholesterol and appropriate cholesterol. There's not really a bad one and a good one. They have jobs. Remember, our bodies are smart. They know what to do with things. Does anybody know what HDL means?
High density lipoprotein.
So lipoprotein are your fats. So a high density. Okay, we're going back in time for all us old people. Remember Pac-Man? Okay, so the little dots. We're eating cholesterol balls. So if I'm a Pac-Man and I have a lot of them and I step on the scale, I'm going to have a high density, right? So they're going to call me an HDL. So if I'm a Miss Pac-Man and I'm a little lazy, sorry, not ladies, ladies aren't lazy, but if we're going and we go abda, 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 and then he jumps on the scale and doesn't weigh as much, he's low density. So during the time when we need to make a lot of hormones, like stress hormone, cortisol, which Rose apparently forgot, we're going to have to be making a lot of hormones because we're under stress response. We're going to need more cholesterol in our blood. So does it make sense to have a lot of our fat Pac-Man hogging up all that cholesterol and taking it into the cells, or does it make more sense to have it up in the bloodstream? Our bodies are smart. Okay, did your eyes glaze over? Did I lose you? Does it make sense? Does that make sense? So it's a little different way of looking at it. If we look at it from the body's perspective and not Oprah's. So someone else. So if we got over here, now we're also going to have increased clotting factors. Why would we do that? Under stress, and when I'm a saber-tooth tiger, I'm going to bite you. There's a high chance if we're in a fight, I'm going to bite you, and you're going to bleed. I fight dirty. Get on. But we're going to do that. So we don't want you to bleed out because you have to survive right now. So we want thicker blood, so it's going to clot a little faster, right? Now, we're also going to have breakdown of muscle and connective tissue. People under stress, my back hurts, I got these knots over here, I don't know why I can't sit all day, I can't walk. Under stress, the body uses glucose, proteins, and fats. Our muscles and our connective tissue are made up of protein. So our body is surviving now. It doesn't care whether we're going to be Mr. America 2 days later. We have to survive now. So we're going to borrow that protein from the muscle and connective tissue, and we're going to use that for fuel. We also have insulin resistance. Does anybody know what insulin does?
No.
Yeah, it does. So when there's high sugars in our blood, Mr. Insulin comes out, all right, come on, shuffles them into the fat cell, sets them over here to get them to keep that homeostasis, that natural balance in our bodies. So our bodies are smart. So we're going to actually resist the insulin, which means we're going to hold them back. Leave our sugar alone. We want it out of the bloodstream. We need it for fuel now. So we get the hell over there and stay over there until further notice. Our bodies are smart. So as we come down over here too, we're also going to look at memory. Here's something really interesting. We have different portions of our brain. We have the brain stem, which actions in our neck. But neck stem does not sound as good. So we use brain stem. And it's about a walnut-sized piece of tissue, about like that. And it's the first thing that's created in your body. When the sperm and egg come together, this is the first portion where the brain is made. It's called the reptilian brain because there's no thinking involved. I call it the Democrat brain. You know, I have a comment for that, but we're being videotaped. Okay, so it sits about right here, and it has no thought process. This is where reflexes come from, this is where respiration comes from, this is where immunity comes from, and everything else like that. When we're under stress, we go down and we think with our reptilian brain. I want everybody to put your thumb in here, like this, and cover this over. Now this represents what your brain looks like. You did wonderful. So this is the thinking part. You know, you see a picture of the brain, and it looks like spaghetti all over. And if you open it up over here, this little piece over here is called the limbic system. And this is where the emotions come from. I don't like emotions. This portion down over here, this is the reptilian brain. This is where survival, this is where just bodily functions come from. The term, flip your lid, comes down from over here where you're thinking emotionally, and you just react. So people, under terms of stress, domestic violence, sometimes, I just lost my mind, I just flipped my lid. I blanked out because you're not cognitively thinking, and I just did whatever I did. And you're living on emotion and reflex. Make sense? Mm-hmm. So when you think about your stressful situation, when you're really stressed, what happens to your body? Do you go, well, you know, let me see. You know, the quadratic equation, coming over here, if we're carrying the square root of that, no, you're not going to do that. So under stressful situations, we're going to have a decreased short-term memory. We're not going to be able to learn, and we're not going to be able to concentrate. This sounds a lot like ADD, ADHD. A good example. The last 4 years, 5 years, how long has the economy been crashed?
2006
forever. That's when I hired, got it on the low end of the market. But we're sitting here. Now, back then, we had a lot of problems. We still have a lot of problems. So your job's at jeopardy, right? So everybody's stressed out. Where's your paperwork? Pat, I can't believe it. This has to be done tomorrow. You have to do this. I need you to concentrate. These are the exact details that you have to get down. Why can't you do this? We need this by 5 o'clock. It's a quarter till. Oh, my God. And you're back on here. Take out the trash, for God's sakes. I can't believe it. What is wrong with... Do you want to lose your job? Am I doing pouring stress on? Putting stress on? Oh, by the way, concentrate on this and give me some good ideas. It can't be possible. So you get more and more stressed. You do a worse and worse job, which adds more and more stress. The other thing is that you're under stress, you're not going to remember a long grocery list. Oh, it's a terrible, terrible outfit. You forget the toilet paper. You know, it's not going to happen. So when you're under stress, cognitively, you cannot work well. Oh my God, she's always saving her life. I think of stress. It's a physiological thing that we're doing. And we're trying to learn, and that doesn't work. Now, this is going to increase anxiety, fear, and depression, because those are natural states. Anxiety is a heightened sense of awareness that you're going to have. It's the fear. Remember the emotion? You're going to increase your fear and all those emotions because you're not thinking with this anymore. You flipped your lid. So if I wave to you like this now, means you're crazy. We're going to decrease serotonin. Serotonin is the happy neurotransmitter. It's our body's natural happy drug. We're going to be doing this, but it's decreased. It's decreased when we're under stress. So this is great for our Paxil distributors, because we're under chronic stress all the time. This is what's going to happen. Also, we're going to decrease digestion. People know somebody that's, whenever they're stressed, they get ulcers. I mean, that used to be the same thing. Wherever you're weak at during a stress time, you're gonna feel that symptom kind of bump up. But think about your smart body. Why is your digestion going to be crap when you're stressed out?
It won't crap.
Good point.
Yeah. Blood's flowing away from the central organs.
It's doing that. The other thing is, when are we trying to survive?
Right now.
Right now. we don't have time to digest the food, and we put a fat, you know, sugar, and we shuffle it to the body. No, we're under stress right now. So we don't have time for this dog. Get it out. We need the stuff that we did. So you don't create hydrochloric acid. Think about when you go out and you're preparing for a good meal. Nice, get some nice ambiance, some good wine, right around. You're sitting over there like that, and you're in a relaxed state, digestive, but things are going on, your mouth is watering over there. How many people, when you're stripped, you dry mouth? Oh my God, it's like chewing cotton. This is not the time for you to digest food. Food and digestion is for tomorrow, because you're building a better body. Not right now, when our smart body knows when we're supposed to be doing things. And it's not under stress. We're also going to increase our sensitivity because we want to know any stimulus that's around our body. And this is not only physical sensitivity, it's also emotional sensitivity.
I told you I thought that was my favorite pen and you ruined it and it was this terrible. You're a jerk.
I've never heard that before. But it's going to increase your sensitivity. So whatever you were sensitive to, what it didn't have to be rational. All it has to do is be. It doesn't have to make any sense. Oh, I'm sorry, you can put my pin anytime you want when things calm down. But it's how it is. We're also going to decrease our immunity. Does that make sense?
No.
No?
Not decreasing the immunity. Why would you do that?
Because I'm glad you asked this. Everybody, my shill, everybody.
My shill. Hello.
Think about it. If I'm a saber-toothed tiger, and I'm not going to bite you now, I'm going to bite you, and I have all saber-toothed tigers spit on me, and I go like this. That white blood cell that's going to protect you from that does you no good. Because all you're worried about is running from there, up that tree over there, and get away from the saber-toothed tiger. The metabolic expense of your immune system is about 80% of your energy. When we eat and we sleep like that, that's building up a lot of our immune. Anybody ever get sick? Cold, flu? Anybody get tired? It's because you're healing. It's a lot. Your immune system takes a lot. It's a very complex system, like computers. And as you're going through this, it takes a lot of energy. We don't have time for that anymore. If we're going to die of diphtheria, let it be tomorrow. I will not die of a saber-toothed tiger bite. So we're going to decrease that immunity. Make sense? Mm-hmm. Kind of makes sense? Good. Here's a couple more things. Decrease the growth hormone, testosterone, luteinizing hormone. Basically what this is, the growth hormone's anti-aging. Anybody under stress, old, tired, beat down, 20 years older than they should. The luteinizing hormone, that's a reproductive hormone. You know, nowadays, in the last 10 years, we've actually had a decrease in our birth rate. I joke, but they've even measured penis sizes have gotten smaller. So all the young kids better watch out, because it's becoming a big problem. The decrease in testosterone. It also has a lot to do with, we have a lot of estrogens in our system, in our water, people popping birth controls like M&Ms. Don't take the green one, it makes you want it. It's kind of what you want. Maybe that's what you want. But we've got to watch out for those things too, because those are decreasing our, we don't need to be big and strong and testosterone right now. When the saber-toothed tiger's app is, we want to scream and run like a girl. We don't need testosterone. We're also going to have bone loss, muscle fiber changes. Our smart body knows that we need calcium to move our muscles. Calcium is stored in the bones. So if we're under chronic stress, acute stress, it depletes all that mineralization of the bone to get it out to be used in these processes. Because we have to survive right now. Muscle fiber change, we've kind of already gone over that with protein breakdown. Brain atrophy. It kind of goes along when we're talking about flipping your lid. But chronic inflammation, chronic stress, and everything like that, your blood and your activity are going to just to survive. It's going to this guy. So this stuff, if you don't use it, you lose it. It just kind of dwindles away. So we're actually seeing smaller brain sizes now for people under stress. the list goes on and on and on, and I could probably spend a month here going over things like that. But I wanted you guys to get an overview about what's going on, because it's important. It's so vitally important that you understand. You don't have to understand it today, so don't stress out. But you guys have to understand how your bodies work and what's working against you in order to combat what's going on. Now, there's three types of stress. You're going to have physical stress, chemical stress, and emotional stress. Physical stress is very simple. But you're in a car accident, you have a sports injury, poor posture. Poor posture is the number one physical stress that we see today. I want you to know that 80% of our jobs spend 80% of our time. Our bodies are required to move. It's not a good idea, it's not something we do, you're not getting 15 minutes of gardening is just as good as walking 14 miles. No, you are required to move constantly, consistently, every day. Paleolithic man on his day off would walk between 9 and 13 miles a day. That's on his day off. We don't do crap. Let's go through the day. Get up in the morning. If you eat breakfast, you're going to eat breakfast. You're going to drive down to work. You're going to go 91, 55, any place to go there. Until you get to your job, you're going to spend 80% of your job. Do this, mouse and mouth it, push with this, check eBay, there's Facebook, you've got everything else for you. Until you have a break time, when you go and you're going to sit with your friends, and you're going to say, I cannot believe it. She got those cookies out, and she didn't have any, but then that's what overstocked. Until it's time to go back over here, we're going back over here. Until it's lunchtime, where you may walk over somewhere, until you sit down and you're going to eat something that comes in a bag or a box or something like that. You're going to sit down here, and it's mostly fake food, so you're taking this in. And then you're going to sit down and do like this until you kind of fall asleep, and you're going to get up back at the game until it's 5 o'clock, and you're going to get back on the freeway and drive over here. It takes twice as long over here, because now everybody's going home at the same time you are. You're going to grab maybe a box or box, but we're going to sit down and eat again over there. Now you finally got a couple hours to yourself because your day's over. Or I'm going to update my Facebook status, and I'm going to do it. So we're sitting all day until we get to going on the weekends, and we try to do something, then we injure ourselves because it just doesn't work. Movement is a requirement. Posture is the biggest single stress that we have going on in a physical manner. Now, if we look at our chemical stresses, we're going to come back over. Chemical stresses are really good. It's the foods we eat. Definition of food is food. The sustenance that we eat for calories. Most of us do not eat true food. You shop around the perimeter of the grocery store. Even if you're doing that, the way the GMOs, the way that the soils are tilled, we're probably not getting the nutrients that we need. But luckily, we have deep fried everything because the fair is in town. And we can take care of it. So there's the foods that we eat. Those cause a chemical reaction in our body. We're coming over here. There's pollution in our air. Just the air pollution, our body has to detox that. It takes a toll on our body. We have the lymphatics, there's a lot of stress on us. Look at that. Arnold Schwarzenegger's cow. I said moo. I'll be calf. So we're sitting over here, but these are the kinds of foods we're eating. So we're picking up more hormones in our food than we've had before. So even if we try to eat some good food, we're really not going to get it. It takes a lot of work, and this is why we're having the class, because we have to be able to sift through the bowl to in order to get to what's going on. Now, the biggest thing that we have going on, too, is our emotional stress. Now, before today, when you came over and got all this education on stress, when you said, I'm stressed out, what's that mean? What stresses you out? I'll bind you. I know you're right. Randy. But most people say, I'm stressed out. I'm really stressed out because work is just sucks. I don't have any money, and I'm just thinking too many bills, not enough money. I'm that woman of mine, I just can't believe it. And there's traffic getting over here, just trying to. Oh my God, I got to go eat brisket in Texas, and I just can't. Oh, there's just so much we have going. And the family problems. If you knew my brother, he was just crazy. Most people think of those are stressful things. And they are stressful things. Those are emotional things. If you look in your packet, I kind of popped in there that when we look at physical stuff, we're looking at muscle, bone, ligament, something that's really tangible that we can touch. You're my proper end. So if we look at our chemical stuff, we're looking at a cellular level. The way things go in, yeah, we can kind of see it with a microscope and everything. We can get an idea, but that's more conceptual. Emotional stress is invisible. You can't see emotional stress because it's different. And it's something you can't see worry, and you can't see unemployment, and you can't see chronic pain. These are subjective things. When somebody comes in here, a lot of times we'll sit down, because I see, you know, I treat a lot of entrepreneurs, I treat a lot of authors and things like that, and I like positive thinking people. Wow, take on the world, I have a great idea, yeah, me too, I'll help you get there. And they have really good positive thoughts, and their brains are great, but their bodies can't keep up. Their minds are writing checks that their body can't cash. Come on, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go to this seminar. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to fly to Texas and eat a brisket. I'm going to go back over here. He flies a lot. That's why I'm going to pick on him. He's always out of here. I think he's on the lam, personally. But you go in and you're going, I'm going to do this. This is going to be fun. And I'm there. Well, one more thing. I can get there. And it just doesn't happen. So we have a lot of things we're taking. And I deal with a lot of difficult cases, too. And there's a lot of stuff that has to be done. It's just like, well, just crack my back and I'll be fine. The body doesn't work like that. The body's smart. So there's a lot of things going on. So when they say, okay, what's one thing that I can do? What I need to change to get healthy and get the life that I want? Just one.
Eat better.
Eat better? The one thing that you have to change before you change everything is change your mind. You have to change your beliefs, you have to change what you know, because what you concentrate on, what you focus on, is what you're going to get. When I talk about it, you have to ask yourself better questions, and this is what we start out with. And it becomes very problematic, because your mind is your biggest issue that you're going to have. Because it will drive everything else. And a good example of this, I got an email. So, Marissa, you're going to be my friend. Randy, I want you to hold this snake right here. Would you like snakes? Do you like them? Okay. So she likes reptiles. I hate snakes. They're just, oh, snakes, they're slithery, and and they have a tongue, and they stick out, and they do stuff, and it's just, oh my gosh. Randy, put the snake right here. That was good background music. What, now we're good? We don't have to edit that in. Hey, hold it, almost got it. So, snake here that's sitting. I'm scared to death. Right now, my cortisol levels, this is me. It's a snake, my heart's going like that, I'm sweating, I can feel the blood glucose going, and it's just like, I'm in fear for my life. Marissa, how you feeling?
Pretty good.
She secretly loves snakes. She has a passion for snakes. She's eyeing that up for Nouvelle. And doing some other stuff over here. So right now, we just went over about everything that went over in my body right now. With cortisol up, heart blood system. The longer that snake's there, the faster I'm dying. I have everything going on in my body that's creating death. Marissa. Brand new Christmas puppy, warm and cuddly, endorphin. This might as well be Brad Pitt because she's just loving it. It's just something else. She's, your endorphins that you were talking about earlier, she's just loving them up. She is doing everything. Her growth hormone's going up. She's getting younger because the growth hormone's up, luteinizing hormone's up, feeling a little sexy, getting everything going down. Everything in her life is good because of that snake. Now, is she seeing a different snake than I am?
No.
So what's the difference between my reaction and her reaction?
It's based on your mindset.
My mindset. It's based on all my beliefs, all my references about snakes. You gave Eve the apple, darn you, and then, you know, everything else. She could be a snake handler, Baptist, you know, Appalachian, snake handler, whatever. You know, she could be just loving the things of it, but she has all her references and her beliefs about snakes are totally different than mine. And it creates a biological change. And the one thing that you need to change before you change anything else is your mindset. And it has to be what you value. Today you guys are going to get a value out of this class that is up to you. Hell, it's free. So, you know, anything else up from there, it's based on what you want. So how many people, what's the biggest value in your life? What do people value most? Family? What? Your life?
Breathing, yeah.
Breathing. Health.
The family.
Family.
Brisket.
Brisket, wine, thin mints, got it, everything going. If you want to know your true values, not the ones that look good on paper, your true value, look at your calendar and look at your bank book. Where you spend your time and where you spend your money, because those are both representations of your efforts and your concentration. And if you really want to know what you're doing, what your values are, look at those two things. Then you'll get the truth. And you may look at that and say, you know what? I really don't value the lotto that much. And maybe I'm going to change something at that point. You guys may not have noticed in the back, or you may have noticed, our wonderful cameraman back there is Dr. Cesar Vargas. He is wave Cesar. Very well-known neurolinguistic program teacher. Every self-help book that's translated into Spanish usually goes through him. He's wrote a wonderful book on that. But he works on mindset. Actually, he has a great webinar coming up that you guys can check out. But it works on the mindset, on techniques, on how to change those things. Because there's always things that we know that we need to do, how to do them, but we just don't do them, and there's something else that stops them over that. So I just wanted to kind of go through that, but it's the biggest thing that you have to do is get your mind right. Now, as we're going to hear, I want you guys to understand, what do I mean there's no pathology? Now that's a lie. There are pathologies. There's, if you have genetic problems, somebody has missing a chromosome, you're going to have Down syndrome 100% of the time. There are things that happen. It is about 2% of all diseases. So we're going to talk about the other 98%. So what I want you guys to learn about today, and what you take away from it is that maybe you don't have a pathology. What you guys are in the middle of is adaptive physiology. And that's everything that we talked about, that whole stress response. Does that make sense? Maybe our bodies have shifted to a certain way, whether it's back pain or neck pain or autoimmune or digestive issues or chronic fatigue, even poor posture can be broken down to adaptive physiology. If you want to get back down to the core of what you're doing, you're going to get through that. So, I don't want anybody to take this the wrong way. But let's go with our traditional. So let's say this guy here, Joe, he's going to the doctor. And he's never been to this class, if you can believe it or not. And he's a pretty healthy guy, young guy. He's 35 years old. He works in corporate, sells pies. But he's going to the doctor, and he's just lived our life, our normal life, just like you. And so goes to, what does that do? He finds out he has high blood pressure. Oh. Well, you could try diet and exercise, but I'm a traditional medical doctor, and I think, that'll keep brain down. Now, I want you guys to go back to our physiology, what our brains tell. When we're under a stress response, our brain is screaming, stress response, survival, survival. So what we're doing is we're turning down the blood pressure quotient. We have all this other stuff going on, we're just going to turn down the blood. Does that turn down the stress? Okay, so there's a feedback. Remember homeostasis way back when you started? So there's a feedback loop, and the brain's going to go, I said we needed more blood pressure. So your brain is going to scream, we're under more stress even than before! Come on, hurry up! Oh! So when next time we go to the doctor, we're going to get our blood test, we're going to find out we have high cholesterol. Well, we all know why we have high cholesterol, right? This doctor thinks Lipitor is the answer. Because Lipitor, you know, that's going to bring it down to the proper numbers that we want to see in our case studies that are just valuable under people just exactly like you under every people. So next time we're going to blood sugar is a little high. It's a little high. You're pre-diabetic. They're making up new diseases just to widen their branch, to widen their market. It's crazy. Do you guys heard of insulin resistance?
Mm-hmm.
Syndrome X, things like that. What's the difference between insulin resistance and diabetes?
You don't have
diabetes,
you don't have insulin. Your body's not producing enough.
That is a wonderful trial. Wrong. Nothing. It's the same physiological response, but just it's like us going down the Overland Boulevard and then it turns over into Weir. We're just driving. It's just a matter of distance. You have insulin resistance here. Just wait a little while. You're going to be diabetic. It's the same thing. You have the same adaptive physiology. You're just not to that degree yet. They like to grade you on that. So metformin. Shark saliva?
Yeah.
I think that's what it is.
Yeah.
Is it? It's somebody's saliva. So, rather than the saber-toothed tiger, we're going to kiss sharks. You come back in your face all like it. Sure, he has diabetes! No! High triglycerides. What are triglycerides? Fats, that's right! So we're going to have high flats in the blood because we have so better get on trifle. So far, what have we been doing? What kind of stresses do we have? Physical?
Chemical
or emotional? So, Joe, we're going to fix him and we're adding more chemical stressors to him, so the brain's going to scream louder. Oh, reflux. Just the problem. Got it. So, did anybody know why we get reflux other than the stress? These are my two shills right here. Yeah, you know what happens? And what do we take antacids because we have too much acid, right? That's not true at all. We've learned that we make decreased amount of acid when we're under stress, right? So as we age, we're under high amounts of stress. We have a lot of processed food. Our body does not produce as much acid. So when we chew foods down like that, what happens normally when there's enough acid, it'll close that sphincter muscle. You're right. When we don't make enough acid, it doesn't close that sphincter muscle. And so when we start churning, doing this stuff, to start digesting, it'll pop it back up into the esophagus. Our stomach has a thick mucus layer. Anybody hungry? Thick mucus layer, or you protect the stomach lining. Our esophagus doesn't have that, so if we get a little acid up over here, we'll feel it burn. It goes up high enough. Exactly. But we've been trained that if we take Malcolm magnesia, we take the pink stuff, Tums, whatever like that, and the symptom goes away, it will cure it. Oh, just take this. Oh, great. How long do I have to take this? Forever. Really? And stay away from, you know, tomatoes cause that. Because tomatoes cause... Well, you ever caused it before, Doc? Wrong way. Prilosec, that's a real good one. So, let's see, had high blood pressure, high cholesterol, high sugar, high triglycerides, now he has reflux. Oh, he's coming to my office. Headache, neck pain, back pain, he's so much breakdown. Oh, what's he going to do?
Flexerol.
Everyone knows that we can fix a mechanical problem with a chemical solution. We proved it time and time again. So he has back pain, he's sitting around, and his energy's low. Really fatigued now. Now he's starting to self-medicate. 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and 4 o'clock to get me through the day. A little sugar, and we'll be in the caffeine and home. So, his girlfriend's not very happy about now. And he's going to have to start getting his synthetic
estrogen.
So,
Jesse's lost his hair and gained weight. Yeah.
Anybody heard of aromatization? Aromatization? Aromatase? This is going to be something that we have a big estrogen problem in our. Guys, you know what I'm talking about. We have, this is what I call an estrogen nation. We have so much estrogen, which is called xenoestrogen, we get them in the food, like I was talking before about birth control pill, that our bodies is not producing properly how they should. They're not producing the proper amounts of hormones. So they're giving us too much estrogen in our body. And one thing that we do know from too much estrogen is that it causes site-specific cancers like breast cancer, uterine cancer, testicular cancer, and things like that. And it's due to so if anybody, well, the women are on hormone replacements, you need to look up, you have to get your hormones checked to make sure you're in balance, that you have enough of this enzyme, or you're going to, when you take the estrogen, it's going to turn it into testosterone. And men, if you have this enzyme going up, that it's going to take your testosterone and turn it into estrogen. You know somebody that has too much estrogen in their body, if the men will get soft, it causes a lot of belly fat. We see this a lot in teenage males. I'll see that. I remember I could eat like 4 Big Macs. I could eat a burrito, 4 pizzas, and whatever on my friend's plate. And, it's like, and when I was in high school, it just turned into muscle because we were just always active. Always moving around. And now you see these athletes, and they're soft. It's almost like the teenage boys have like a little cellulite because it's so much fat underneath it. That's, it has a lot to do with the estrogen. So, this can turn us into autoimmune disease. There's a condition called leaky gut that has a lot to do, I won't get into because it's a big deal. But this is this sense for autoimmune problem. Autoimmune is when your body starts attacking itself. It's not a good thing. All they do for that is prednisone because you're inflamed. I've had really good results with a lot of autoimmune thyroid conditions because we treat under this model, physical, chemical, and emotional. But we've been balancing them out because what thyroid, for example, you have autoimmune thyroid, Hashimoto's disease, they keep treating you with these chemicals to get your numbers back, feeling, even though you feel like crap the whole time, but they want to see the numbers right in there. And they keep on treating the thyroid, when this is autoimmune. It's an immune issue, and you should need to treat that first, then you can get rid of everything else. So this is just something that you do, because otherwise, they're just going to be on drugs. So there's depression that'll pop in, and then he starts getting his Paxil. So we took a relatively healthy person that we could have turned around over there, and we just made him a bundle of joy here. But does anybody know somebody like this? If you've watched them over the years, maybe 3, 5, even 10 years, oh yeah, he has blood sugar problems, this stuff. Well, now he has this. And most people, you forget about the ones in the past that were in 2 years ago, and you don't connect the dots I said, yeah, you know, I have high blood sugar. You know, I was pre-diabetic and not diabetic. And I think feet tingle, and I can't do this. And I have, well, my stomach hurts. It's all the same thing. Our body works together. Our body's smart. When we start to try to overcome that, it becomes a problem. So what does all this mean? Because this is how most of us are treated. Increased cortisol, obesity, diabetes, and cancer. And you notice you're always going to see diabetes and cancer together in heart disease, just because it's a physiological thing. Increased heart rate, there's your stroke, there's your heart disease, the blood viscosity, the blood pressure, blood sugar. You can kind of see how this goes. High lipids, heart disease, stroke, fatigue. What's the number one killer in the United States? Heart disease. What's number two? Stroke. Cancer. Number three? You know number three?
Medical care.
No.
What is it?
Medical care. And I'm not the guy that says that we need to beat up a medical profession, because they are a good profession and they do great work and they have great hearts. They have a wrong paradigm. And they're treating Joe like that. You could be Joe. You could be Joe. You can't be Joe. You can be Joe. But you're going to see this time and time and time again. They're really good people, but they're just treating the symptoms. And it's more important now than ever that we understand how our bodies work. We have to walk around in these bodies for the rest of our lives. So when I call patients, when I see this, because this is just kind of like what I do, but I sit here and somebody comes in with back pain or headache and like that, you know, the stuff that people usually come to chiropractors for. And I do a history and we sit down and say, well, you gotta do this, I guess, and then they go off. And I call you a little while later. I say, you know, you need to get an important appointment because we gotta keep this up. I know my back and my neck really don't hurt that bad. No. Symptoms aren't good, but I know in my heart that your diabetes is flaring up, you're doing this and like that, and you need attention, you need to get the nervous system taken care of, you have to do this, and it's important. But I see Joe all the time. And the problem is with Joe is he didn't know. So you guys are screwed because now you have no excuse, you know. And now more than ever, you have to know. Because sometimes, remember I said look at your values? Let's pretend that you don't care about how your long-term health, you don't want to run a marathon, you want to be the best version of yourself that you can be. You're really concerned about the money. How much can I put in my pocket? How much can I save? What can I do? That's okay. I'm not going to judge your values. But one thing that I do know, healthier people make more money. Healthier people think clearer. Healthy people that think clearer are going to have a distinct market advantage ahead of those people whose brains are atrophying, who are chronically under stress, who are always on drugs, always doing this. Because most of the people, right now, we are in a time of this world where we have more resources, more information at our fingertips. At the exact same time, we have the least direction. You can Google anything. You can Google stress, cortisol, aromatase. But you don't have the background and the knowledge doing what else to do. How many people knew what LDL was? But you're learning something, but you're going to see how you get to put it all together. And when you can put the pieces together, you can make better decisions because you can ask better questions. But most of us we're getting it. Oh, question. Just put it out there on Facebook, and whoever says the most right answer, I'll do that. Or, you know what? I read Dr. Oz said, I need GABA. Anybody hear of GABA? It's a supplement they have, kind of relax you, do like this, and this, that. You know what? If GABA works on you, you're sick. I go to the health food store all the time and I look at it and GABA's sold out. And say, oh. If GABA is able to get into your brain, it means that you've breached the blood-brain barrier because that molecule is too big to get through a normal sized brain. So as people are, I'm like a natural. GABA, it's good. I saw it at Dr. Oz and he said it would work and I feel great. Just palliating yourself until you die a little bit faster. We're not getting the direction. That's why I hold these classes, because I want this information to get out. And the resources are out there. The research is out there that we can get a lot of this stuff you guys are suffering from, to let you know you're suffering from. More importantly, you can make better decisions based on what you're learning today. Just a little stuff that you're going to take away. And I know you won't remember everything. That's okay. But when one of your kids is sick, or your spouse is sick, and they start spotting off about something, at least you can ask some different questions.
What are you doing up here? I thought you were downstairs boxing chocolates.
Oh, they kicked me out of there fast.
Why?
I kept pinching them to see what kind they were.
This is the pancreas.
This is the fourth department I've been in.
Oh, I didn't do so well either.
Oh,
that's the brain.
Girls, now this is your last chance. If one piece of candy gets past you and into the packing room unwrapped,
those are liver proteins coming across. This is homeostasis. Complete balance of everything that's going on. Pancreas and everybody working well together.
Well, this is easier.
It's easy.
We can handle it, okay?
They can handle it, okay, all day. Oh, there's the tiger. Uh-oh. Look, Dora. Goes away. Oh, got me. Government shut down.
Listen.
Oh, no. There she goes down. There you go. It's survival. How we can't let it get by. This is, what are we going to do? This is just crazy. Oh, this is just not going to work. I mean, oh my gosh, this is estrogen. Oh, aromatase. You can't get it. Yeah. Oh, they got back up. Oh, this stroke. Can't keep up. Renal fatigue. I feel like older. Digestive issues. Brain's coming back in to check
fine.
In.
Fine, you're doing splendidly. Speed up!
So, now we look at this differently from homeostasis. What happened in there? The chocolate went through, it came off the conveyor belt, got in the hat, some got on the floor, some got through there. The little tissues that they're wrapping in, those were all over the place. It was in the hat, in the mouth, on the shirt, so these were dirty. How much stuff, if you looked specifically, got messed up in that, and things got out of balance, and things came awry, when every piece of the pie didn't do its job, when you're out of homeostasis. This is, only a chiropractor would look at that. You know what, that's just like the renal access, and like, we have to learn about this. Any questions? Comments, complaints. This is us. This is what we do. We have chiropractic, functional medicine, specific nutrients to support your body, to help it heal itself, to get through. Diplomat spinal trauma, I went through law school, and we do a lot of stuff with spinal biomechanics and the like. You know, here's something else for you guys, speaking of Obamacare. A lot of people are having high deductibles, and they're having either that or just don't have insurance. We have we order blood tests over here. They're about 60 to 70% less than you would get at LabQuest or something like that. It's a co-op, and there's like four draw sites around here that we can order the tests over here. So if you guys know anybody or you have that issue coming up and you just want to get your blood tested to see how you're doing. The educational classes are really important to me because this is our mission. It's to help Yorba become the healthiest city in which we can have our office be the education and service hub of that vision. First thing is education. It's why I have these classes. It's why we do that, is to empower you guys to make the right decision. Because honestly, I want to retire. And the opposite, I have to wait until everyone's healthy and everybody knows all this stuff until we're able to do that. The stuff is out there. If you guys know anybody, the referral that's going to keep the vision going, that's going to make a tribe of healthy people, and we can take our little world up in Yorba Linda, and then we're going to infiltrate Anaheim Hills and down into Orange and Placentia. Maybe not Placentia. We'll get into Placentia. We're going to take on North Orange County. We're going to go to the rest of Orange County. Once we hit the counties, we're going to go. I'm not a Dodger fan. We might go around LA, but we'll knock that out a lot. But this is what we want to do. I have a couple things for you. I was to ask you this question again about what causes stress, would you have different answers? Would you?
More important.
Now, more importantly, is that what stress caused? Would you have different answers?
Mm-hmm.
All right, my job's done. Dr. Vargas is offered to do a free consultation for any mindset stuff that we have. He said, anybody familiar with NLP or neuro-linguistics programming? Ron, you can know about that. All the NLP, I guess. It's about how to work your mind. Your mind is not your brain, but it's just some mindset stuff. If you have a struggle with getting something done, if there's a limiting belief that you have over there, there's just some techniques that what do we do with you? We chocolate?
Yes.
How long did that take?
10 minutes.
How much chocolate are you having now?
I can't eat it.
It was but she was addicted to chocolate. And there's techniques and there's just things. Sorry. So there's healthy chocolate. It was the bad chocolate. It wasn't your chocolate.
I assume.
Yeah. But there's a lot of technique, and he's an expert. He teaches the stuff like that. Then he's offered to give you guys consultations. But write Caesar, Dr. Vargas, on that. If you guys would like him to contact you, and do that. And we have one more thing. I think he's offered. Here's a book, Your Life is Your Masterpiece. We're going to raffle that off. All right, you guys, any more questions? I'll be right here just putting away if you have any more questions.
Thank you very much.
All you.
Thank you.
Hey, this is Dr. Bill Janeshak. You just watched my seminar on Never Say It's Just Stress Again. I hope you really got something out of it. I want to let you know it just really comes from the heart. I extended an offer to the people in the audience about coming in for a consultation. Let's just talk about your problems, what you have going on, and maybe some questions that were brought up. After every seminar, we always get specific questions on people. So this is going to be an opportunity for you to go ahead and contact us. You can get the website here or on that at www.yorbalindafamilychiropractic.com. Or call our office at 714-777-2500 and just tell them that you've watched this and you're going to take me up on my offer about a free consultation. And we can do that live here in the office if you're local. If you're out of the area though, you know, give us a phone call or maybe a Skype and we can get that all set up for you. Our goal here is, like you saw on the videos, to help Yorba Linda become the healthiest city in Orange County. But I want to extend that out to where you guys are at as well. I really want to make a difference, and I hope I make a difference with you. And when you call, I'm going to give you everything that I got. So thanks a lot. I look forward to talking with you soon. Thanks a lot.